Welcome back guys. In the last video we have discussed about the draw commands. If you are not aware of that commands, check it out in the I button. In this video we are going to discuss about the modify command. So let's get started. First I am going to show you the move command. To use that, type M, press enter. Select the object, press enter, select any point as the base point. Now I am going to move it inside this rectangle. As you can see, by using the move command, I can move an object from one point to another point. This is very easy command. I hope you understand. Now let me show you what is a copy command. Type copy. The copy command is used to copy those objects which cannot be drawn repeatedly and which are very complex. As you can see in this diagram, I have made a tank which is quite complicated to draw again and again. So I can use the copy command. Select the object, press enter, select any point for my base, then make multiple copies just by dragging this to various positions. Now let me show you what is a rotate command. By rotate, if I want this tank but in a horizontal direction, I cannot draw it again and again. So that in that case you can use the rotate command. To use that, type rotate, select the object, press enter, select any point for your base, select the angle that you want, press enter. Now you can see I make a vertical tank in a horizontal position. Now let me show what is mirror command. If I want this tank but in opposite direction, I cannot draw it again, then I can use the mirror command. Simply select this object, press enter, specify any point for the axis, first point and the second point. Here you can see I have make another copy, but this is facing in the opposite direction. This is the advantage of the mirror command. Now let me show you what is a trim command. The trim command is very simple. Suppose I have draw a line like this. And I don't want these extra entities, then you can use the mirror command. Sorry, trim command. Trim, double enter, select this point and this line, and you can see I have erased the extra entities by using the trim command. Now let me show you what is a scale command. To show you that, I will go to this tank. Using the scale, I can make an object quite large or small. Let me show you. Select the object, press enter, select any point for the base. The base point will be fixed on that point. Then you can simply drag to the upper position or the lower position for making it large or small. And you can also type the scale factor. Suppose I type 2 for the scale factor, it will increase to it double size. Now let me show you what is a fillet command. The fillet command is used to make fillet. Let me show you. select this line and this line. Sorry, first you have to enter the radius. For that, type R, press enter, enter the radius. Suppose I want a radius of 10 units. Then select the first line and the second line. Let me show you another technique. Suppose this is a rectangle which is a polyline. I want to make 4 fillets, so I can do it 4 times, or either I can use fillet type polyline. For that, type P, select this polyline. Sorry, let me try again. Fillet P, enter the radius. The radius is 10. Now select this object, and here you can see I have made 4 fillet at the same time. Now let me show you what is a chamfer. To recover that the earlier original rectangle, Ctrl plus Z. Now use the chamfer command. The chamfer command is used to make a chamfer around the 2D profile. For that, you can use the distance, angle, and as I say, this is a polyline. I have to make 4 chamfer, so I can use polyline type P. Set the angle, suppose the distance is 10 units. The angle is 45 degree. Now select. Now you can see I have made chamfer around this rectangle. Now let me show you what is the polar array. For that, I erase all these tanks first. Now type array. Simply select this object. Press enter, select the rectangular array. The rectangular array make multiple columns and rows. You can adjust the columns and rows. Suppose I want 10 columns and 10 rows. Here you can see I make multiple copies of a simple tank. Close array. Now if you can also do with this. Now I want a tank around this circle, then you can type array. Simply select the object, press enter, then select the polar option. The polar option, then select the center point, then you can type the number of items that you want. Suppose I want 20 and close. Similarly, if I want a tanks, number of tanks following this path, then you can choose the array path option. Again go to array, select the object, then use the path option, type P A for the path. Select the curve. Now you can see number of tanks are following this path. This also moves the tanks along the path. You can also adjust by associative, base point, angle. These are for advanced users. This is okay for us today. Now let me show you what is offset command and export command. If I want to export this rectangle, which means splitting the rectangles into lines, then I will type export. Select the object, press enter, and you can select this line. Now I can array that again. I want to array this line along this path. then I choose path, select the object. Then as a tank have its own chain, I have drawn that. Similarly, you can also mirror that. Now let me show you what is an offset command. For that, I simply draw a line. Type offset. Simply type the offset distance. Select the object and choose the direction. By using the offset command, I can make a line parallel to this. Let me show you. For this arc, I cannot draw it again because I use this line and no dimension. Then you can use the offset command. Select this, and like this you can make that. You can also adjust the distance. Suppose I want a distance of 50 units. Then select this line, and here it is. You can make multiple offsets by doing this. Thank you. This is all for today's guide. Thank you. Have a nice day.